And welcome back to Beverly's Design Time. Tonight I am going to do a DIY which takes a little bit of patience, but the end results are beautiful. I'm calling this one Diamonds and Pearls, and you'll see why. Okay, to do this project you'll need some marbles, and I picked these up at Dollar Tree. And here I have like some half pearl rounds. Pick these up at Michael's. I have a candlestick holder, but I'm not using the ones from Dollar Tree because they tend to lean. And for the time and the elegance that you will see once this project is done, you would not want to use a Dollar Tree base for it. I'm using two of the Dollar Tree tea lights. You'll need some type of strong glue. And I'm using E6000, but you can use Gorilla Glue or some type of epoxy glue. I would not recommend using any type of hot glue for this project. You would need a hurricane vase. I picked this one up at Michael's. They had the ones at Dollar Tree that was about this tall, and it really wasn't the height that I needed. They didn't have the taller ones that they normally carry, so I ended up going to Michael's and purchasing this one. I've also found these at Walmart, but yeah, I really wanted a tall look. I didn't want it this tall, but after it's done, you'll see it really adds to the look, okay? So you'll need some type of bling wrap. I picked this up on Amazon, but you can use the regular Dollar Tree bling wrap if you want to. All right, so let me set this aside and get this project started. Oh, and one other thing, you will need a glue gun, but just temporarily, and you'll see why. Okay, so what I want to do is take four marbles and glue these around my first tea light. But I'm going to use hot glue for this because later I want to pop these marbles back off. So once these marbles set, I'm going to use my epoxy glue to glue this top on top of those marbles. And I'll let that set for 24 hours. Well, maybe 12 to 24 hours. And then once it's dry and once that's done, I'll come in and pop the marbles loose from the base where I used the hot glue, if that makes sense. But you'll see. So I'm going to use my low heat glue gun and put just a little. You want just a little bit because you want to be able to pop this off with no problem. So what I'm going to do now is go straight across from here, and that looks about right. And I'm not putting my marble directly in the center of the tea light because I kind of wanted to go over the edge just a little. Hold it until it sets. And you can hold it up and look at it and see if it's setting to the outside too much. I think I want to move this one. Okay. So now what I want to do is do the same thing here and here. Okay. Remember, just a really small amount. Okay. So now just take the top and try and get an idea as to where you need to sit it. And if you need to move any of the marbles around. And here I like to use the level. And they also sell these at Dollar Tree. You may have to lean down and get eye level with it. Okay, so it's still not level. So that's telling me I need to move one of my marbles around, and I think it might be this one. So So I'm just going to relocate the marble. This is the most time consuming part of this project, I think. Okay. All right, that looks pretty good. So now what I need to do is take my E6000 and remember to use your E6000 in a really well ventilated area. So what I want to do now is just go ahead and put some glue here. Try not to let it run over the sides. Okay, so now what I want to do is add a little bit to the top. Because I really want to have a strong bond. Check the level. So that's leveling up pretty good. So I'm going to let this sit for at least 12 hours, maybe 24, but I just want to make sure that I have a really strong bond between my marble and my top layer. And once that's done, I'll come back in and we'll pick up on step two. Hi guys, I'm back, and it's been about 16 hours since I first glued this together. So I just found this little thing. It's just the bottom part of this little, the little plastic things that you use to make ice creams. Yeah, so all I want to do is just, I don't want to use metal because I don't want to crack the glass. So I'm just going to use this to press on the bottom part of the marble to get it to release. You could probably use a plastic fork or a knife also. Alright. So now you just clean up whatever you can from the extra glue. And be careful, don't put too much pressure. Just make sure you clean up all of the hot glue that you have on the marbles. Make sure you clean the rest of the glue from your other tea light holder. I like to use witch hazel to make sure it's really clean. So now you want to take your E6000 and do the exact same thing as before. Press it down. Check for level. That looks pretty good. Turn it around one last time. All right. So I'm going to let this cure for about 6 hours, then I'll come back and we'll go on to the next step. Okay guys, I'm back, and it has been about 6 hours, and the reason I waited for 6 hours is because I wanted it to set up some before I went on to the next step. So what I want to do now is add 4 more marbles on top of this one. You can add more if you want to, but this is just my choice, and I choose to do it between these two, like right here. So what I'm going to do is use my glue gun again. Turn this and see exactly where I want it positioned. That's good. Now I'm going directly across from that. First time I use my low temp gun, but this should be fine. Okay. Now I want to add one here. And remember, just a little bit, not much. Okay. Thinking I might need to move this one. Yeah, I'm gonna have to come back and move that one over. So I'm going to put this one here. Okay, that looks about right. So now I'll go ahead and add some E6000 to each one of these marbles and then glue my vase on top. And guys, remember the way that you took it off and try to put it back exactly the way it was. So I'm just going to take some of my witch hazel and clean up some of these glue strings. So now I'll just replace it the way that it was. Now I'll go ahead and add some type of weight to it, and I'm going to let this dry another 16 hours, and then once it's done, we'll come in and put the base on and finish it up. Okay, now that this has set up some, it hasn't been a full 24 hours, so I'm kind of reluctant to go ahead and pop it loose, but I'm going to go ahead and give it a try. So I'm just going to flip this over and use my the same little gadget that I had before. I'm just going to apply some pressure between the marble and the base. Try and break the glue. Yeah, I would go ahead and stick with the low temp glue gun because as you can see, it's a little bit harder to get the hot glue off when you use the high temp. So now I'm going to add the E6000 to the top of these marbles. All right. Put the cap back on. I'm going to sit this here. Now I have an idea where I need to put the glue here, so I'm just going to add a little bit more E6000 to this part. Alright, so I'm going to let this set up for about an hour, then I'll come back and glue the base on, and then I'll let that sit an additional 24 hours, and then we'll come back and decorate it. Okay guys, so this has been sitting up now for about 3 hours. So now I'm just going to go ahead and add my base, which is the candle holder that I picked up at the Goodwill. And remember, I'm putting glue on both pieces because I really want a strong hold. Press down. Move it around. Try and get it as even as you can. Pull this forward. Now I'm going to apply this crystal ball for weight. I apply the weight because I want to make sure that I have the pressure that it needs to secure a good hold. And now I'm just going to use some more of the witch hazel to clean up whatever leaked out. Be very gentle. Okay, so now I'll let this sit for 24 hours. And then when it's done, I'll come back and we'll go ahead and finish it up. Hi everyone. It has been about 16 hours since I glued the last piece together. And as you can see, it's really beautiful just like it is. Really gorgeous. If you would like to enforce it a little bit more by adding some more glue to the marbles or wherever you think it might need, then you would, you know, then I would say go ahead and do that. But I'm fine with the way it is. So what I want to do now is go ahead and decorate it. So now I'll just show you how I plan to use the bling. I'm just going to go around and measure, and as you can see, it overlaps, so I need to cut here. Beauty of this is you can cut the bling if you need to. So as you can see, I'll just raise it here, how it overlaps. So I'm just going to cut part of my bling. Can you see that? And be careful while doing this, you don't want to break it. It's not as clean here, so I can just straighten it up later, but this would be in the back. So now you can kind of overlap it if you need to. Okay? So this is for the bottom. And I wanted to add blink at the top too. So what I did was cut off the same amount, but I went right down the middle because it's six in a row. So now I have three for this one. Okay, as I showed you earlier, I have these little half round, pearls. And what I want to do is add some of my pearls to my bling. And I'm actually going to kind of stagger them. I'm going to use some pearl halves about this size. And then for the next row, I'm going to go between those with smaller pearls. Going to use this size. And what I'm going to do is like put one here. Take one of the smaller ones and put it here. I'm going to use my tweezers to use it. Put one here. A smaller one here. Smaller one here. And then I'll just keep this going all the way down. So the next row, I will use these again right here. And then the very next row after that, I'll use these. What I'm going to do is take my glue gun and glue each one of these little pearls on here before I attach it to my glass face. Yours exactly the way that I'm doing mine. You do the top piece, you'll use the bigger pearls here and here, you'll skip one in the middle, and then you'll just use the smaller pearl in the middle. But it's up to you guys. You can add more pearls or less, or don't add any at all. And you can also use just the regular Dollar Tree bling wrap. You don't have to use this. All right, so let's just finish this up. Now that I'm done putting my pearls on my bling, I'm ready to go ahead and glue it on. And I'll be using my glue gun again because I might want to remove this later and add something different, or just leave it as it is. Like I said, it's a really pretty piece alone. And I need to do some additional cleanup, and I'll go in later and do that. There's still some glue strings here and there, but I'll do that later. But what I want to do is start. Let me lay this down. I want to start on the piece that I cut. And I'm just trying to line it up with the edge. this piece kind of came apart, so. Okay, so I'm just going to lift it and turn it very easy. To keep it from rolling, I'm just going to put this here. And I guess I want to put the next roll of glue here. Going to lift it and turn it very gently. Now repeat the same thing with the top piece. You want to line this up with the bottom piece. Guys, when you move your piece, try and support the top part and the bottom. And now you just clean up your glue webs. I'm going to use my blow dryer to get the ones, the really tiny ones. But I kind of enjoy getting the bigger ones. Okay, guys, there's the piece. Yeah, but that's it, guys. So all I need to do now is come back in and clean up the glue webs. And it'll be done. You can use this as a candle holder or you can use it as a vase. It's up to you. It's really, really pretty. So I'm going to go ahead and clean up the glue webs and then I'll come back and show you both of the pieces together. Okay, guys. This is the set. My completed set. And as you can see, they're exactly the same. They both have the four marbles here and four here. I think it would be really cute if you have like a Victorian style living room or dining room or maybe even bedroom. But yeah, these are really beautiful. I'm really happy with them and they didn't cost the arm and a leg. But you can make these guys for a little bit of nothing. So that's it and I hope you really enjoyed this. And if you did, please leave me a thumbs up. And if you are a YouTube creator or if you're just someone that's gonna make these, please don't hesitate to give me a shout out. I would really appreciate it. If you are a subscriber, please make sure you hit the notification button. And if you're not, please subscribe now so you won't miss my next DIY, which will be out soon. Yeah, that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'll see you in the next one. Thanks so much for watching.